More bleeding black. Oh, hell with it. The Impressionist painted the light. What do I paint? Darkness.
Voices from Another Room by Philip Martin, with Neil Dudgeon and Jenny Howe.
Jane? Jane, you back?
I'm trying to keep the house just as it was.
That's scary.
What the?
Well on it, Lily.
I don't mind the shivers. It's worth it just to be allowed to see his paintings.
Hello?
There's a patio. Bit of garden.
Can I see?
Voices. They're coming towards me.
That's one of his earliest works.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it's a cool one.
Like ghosts from the past.
His work is so evocative.
It was the end of his first period. There's only a dozen in existence.
Who are you talking about?
The jagged lines, the colours, so much violence.
Well, it became a constant theme. Well,
what are you...
Premonition?
Building to that awful climax.
In this house.
15 years back.
What?
In this room?
No, I'll show you where later.
That smear of purple, so impressive.
Come on, we need to go through the kitchen.
I'm going bonkers, bonkers. Bloody voices.
Jane? Jane.
Hi. I need to change. The hospital wants me in an hour early. Bloody awful day. That cow at the office wants pre-IT statistics. Tom, you okay?
Yeah. Tea?
Give me half a cup. You look washed out.
Bit cold.
Light the stove.
I'll chop some wood.
We need to sell a few of your pictures, then I could just do the one job.
It'll come.
I know it will.
Jane?
Yeah? What? Tom?
I keep thinking there's someone in the house.
There is. Me.
Other voices.
With people living on either side. That's all it is. Neighbours' voices.
Yes, right. Yeah, of course. Bloody axe!
I thought I'd have a hammock over there. What do you think?
I like that.
You stretched out, a perfect picture. Youth and beauty.
They must be next door. Let's just do a bit of a Tarzan here. And... nothing. No one. Oh, just a bloke up a tree hearing voices going mad. You?
Yes, me. Muggins.
What is it, Jane?
Nothing.
But?
I thought you were in your studio. You'd left the light on.
Wasting electricity. Oh, dear.
The same painting's been on your easel for the last 10 days.
I did a bit today.
I do two jobs. Can't you do one?
Look, I'll ask for more classes.
You're a painter, not a teacher.
I can't seem to concentrate. The least sound, I'm distracted.
Tonight... I watched an old man die. The doctors withdrew, the nurses left me with him. I held his hand and watched his life ebb away. He said he'd left nothing behind. I'll leave nothing behind. You've got talent, Tom. Use it.
Oh, simple.
It's promising, better than arriving. Is that the real problem?
No, it isn't.
Everyone's been waiting for you to burst through. Bring your talent to market.
I didn't stick the most promising label on myself.
You're 32. I'm 40. No kids. I work all hours.
Can we leave this?
We never discuss anything properly.
Well, I get tired too.
From the labours of the day.
Oh, just shut up, okay? Just bloody well shut up!
Let go, Tom!
That voice of yours. Mummy knows best. I hate it. Hate it!
I'm not allowed a voice.
Oh, look, I'll work tomorrow. Even if it's crap, I'll work tomorrow.
Good.
I sell a picture of his every year. The price doubles every time.
Murder pays.
You bought his house? This house?
And everything in it. I spotted the potential of the paintings before anyone else.
Shrewd.
Yes, I cornered that market.
Did the murder happen in this room?
Murder?
No, I'll show you where later.
Who are you talking about?
If you're good.
I'm always good.
Who are you?
Shall we go upstairs?
Richard.
Just to view the paintings.
Well, that's what I'm here for.
What, to persuade me?
Hopefully.
What's happening to me? And a beach. A strip. Black. Purple. Not that. More like a bruise. Bruised. Jane's arms. Why do that to her? Purple. Bleeding into black. Black beach. Purple skyline. Colours of pain. 15 years back, the voices said. And the guy said obsessed with violence, but me? And they mentioned colour. Vivid colour. Well, all I paint is the darkness. Like this. Darkling. Black on black. All in black. 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 Black.
What's that? No one. 15 years back, their voices said. I'm 15 years back. They're in the future talking about me. An awful event involving me. Me and Jane. Jane? No. What would she have to laugh about?
You are funny.
Very funny.
What?
Painting the white black, totally black.
It was no good, Jane.
You're giving up. You've worked months on that painting.
Dead end. It happens.
What happens?
I start another or I give up.
To do what?
If I can't do, I'll teach.
Just like that?
I might be cracking up. My finger marks on your arms. I can't believe I could do that. I never want to hurt you, Jane.
I bruise easily.
We both do.
I can support you, love you, give my life to you, but I can't do the real work for you.
Do you ever hear strange sounds?
I told you. Old terraced houses, the sounds leak through.
Yeah. Yeah, that must be it.
The guy himself. He looks tough. Prison haircut.
That was the fashion.
Well, you keep your hair short. You look a little like him.
We're similar types. I'm the custodian of Tom's work. People like you are all over him now, but I got him first.
Don't you think it might be good to share? The gallery I work for would ensure everything. There would be huge interest in an exhibition of his stuff. His sale price would increase. You could bask in the glory.
I can bask in here, in his house. His paintings are on every wall. I could have sold a collection for millions, turned this house into a museum. I've had enough offers.
But you prefer to keep his art all for yourself.
Not completely. I've let you in.
Why was that, Richard?
Share my pleasure.
In the paintings?
What other pleasure could we possibly share, Lily?
I just love his work.
I keep the prime stuff in my bedroom. Photographs in here, his best work there.
An exclusive view of Tom Swinnerton's work?
Me? They're talking about me.
I'm prepared to share that with you, yes.
I'm the guest, stuck here watching the future unfold. An unquiet spirit. Where have they gone?
There you are. A self-portrait of Mr. Tom Swinnerton himself.
That's truly wonderful.
It's his best self-portrait. I lie in bed. He stares at me, I look at him, I never tire of it. Electric blues, blood reds. The angle's just right. Let me show you.
I don't remember painting that. All those colours.
Come on. Nothing will happen. Sit next to me. Lean back. Now.
Those eyes of his. You can see into his soul. Ooh, it's scary.
Don't look too long.
He's watching us.
I can turn him to the wall.
No need.
Self-portrait. Scary, they said.
Portrait of what? Who? And scary. Why scary? Yeah. Yeah, you do have that convict look. Axeman chic, baby. The mirror never lies. Where's that red? Yeah. Smear the stuff on. Yeah. That's you, at last. You, on that canvas. You.
Go on.
What?
I'm sorry if I made you jump.
Oh, it's only something I'm trying out.
You haven't done a self-portrait for years.
Yeah, well, I am now.
The colours. Blues and reds.
I'm experimenting.
I can see that.
It isn't finished.
I know that, Tom.
I can use any colour I like, OK?
It's the look, the power. It's so different. What happened?
Nothing. Nothing's happened. I'm just trying something out, okay?
Was there a lot of blood?
When we stripped the bathroom walls, yes. There were bloodstains.
It happened here?
Above. The blood must have dripped through the floorboards.
Oh, horrible.
I photographed the stain.
Will you two shut up?
It's like the final phase of Van Gogh.
That is perceptive.
Van bloody Gogh! Can't you pretentious, sex-starved bastards let me take a leak in peace?
Tom? Who are you talking to?
Them! Mr. Art Collector and the Art Gallery Scout.
I can't see anyone.
You heard voices?
Only yours.
He's showing her the house, our house. He owns it. They talk about me, my work. He shows her pictures I haven't painted yet. They mention me, what I might have done to you. I can't stand that thought. I'm scared, Jane.
How long have you worked today?
Oh, it's not that.
All day?
First I worked too little, now it's too much.
Tom, let's calm down. We'll have a drink, yes?
They talk about terrible things.
Yes.
He's showing her every room. They're climbing up to the top of the house. There's something terrible waiting there.
There's only your studio.
I know.
He hears voices. He's an artist. His work has changed radically. Now it's electric colours, bold, vivid, jagged representation. It's as if everything his eye falls on becomes vibrant, alive. I am really worried, Doctor. Yes. Yes, he grabbed my arms. He shook me hard. I know you work with patients who suffer from schizophrenia.
Man, standing. Head, shoulders, blue, like dead flesh. What?
Tom, I'm sorry. Can we talk? Now, don't get upset.
What? About what?
It's only a precaution.
Yeah, we know all about those. But yes, well, what? Spit it right out.
I think you should visit a doctor.
Why? For what reason?
Your behaviour's erratic. You fly at me, you blame me for everything. You say you're hearing voices.
So?
Do these voices suggest that you must do things, follow orders?
No. They don't know I'm there. It's as if I were a ghost, listening into their chat.
Tom, there are no voices.
I know.
You know?
They've stopped. No more. Gone.
There is a condition.
Yes, I know. I know what it's called.
People with that condition who paint...
Look, I'm not schizophrenic, Jane. The voices weren't telling me to kill you.
Well, that's nice to know.
They're not telling me anything at the moment, okay?
You're sure?
Silent as the grave.
Tom...
I'm in the middle of something.
Later, then.
Fine. Now, portrait. Blue. Mirror. There he is. There I am. A man listening in on his own future. Some of my paintings have disappeared.
I've sent them to London. Clive is knocked over by the new work. He wants to show them around.
Why didn't you ask me?
I wanted Clive to confirm my opinion.
Oh, how crap they are, how crap I am.
He thinks he can interest someone like the Marlborough.
Oh, Mummy knows best.
I didn't want you to be disappointed.
Oh, think I can't handle that, bitch.
Me?
Conniving.
I did it for you.
I'm not a child. I can take setbacks. I've had enough practice.
Through being married to me?
No, Jane, no. We mustn't fight.
Look, you're right, whatever. It's me. I'm wrong. I'm sorry. Sorry. It's just that what's going on, the change of style, it scares me. We mustn't quarrel. We mustn't fight. I'm frightened where it might lead.
Tom, what are you saying? What are you trying to do to me?
I'm trying to save your life, Jane.
You like the house?
I like it very much.
Some people wouldn't.
Well, screw them.
I hoped you'd say that.
Oh, kisses even. Part of the tour.
You're the first woman I've allowed in here.
Shut up! Shut up! Leave me alone! Would you like a drink? Tea?
What's the matter? Tom, do you feel okay?
Well, did you hear something? A woman's cry?
No, nothing. Is there someone home?
I don't know. Jane? Hello?
Jane's your wife?
Yes.
What is it?
I've just realised, apart from her, you're the first woman I've brought into this house.
You want me to go?
Oh, no, no.
I'd like to stay. I'd love to see your work. Tom, you promised.
My studio's at the top of the house.
What? Lily?
I just realised we didn't turn Tom's face to the wall.
Maybe he learned a few new tricks.
I'm sure he did.
Well, wait till you see his studio.
Later, not now. Richard?
Hmm?
Is there someone in the house? Someone downstairs?
No.
Oh.
We're alone.
You, me, Tom Swinnerton.
Quite a threesome.
What do you think of them, Natalie?
I had no idea. Some of these, they're so good. And not what I expected at all.
What did you expect? Safe, predictable, boring?
No, it's just when you teach, you seem, I don't know, defensive.
Young people, all that certainty staring back at you.
You talk like an old man. What are you, pushing 40?
Early 30s.
Sorry. How long have you been married?
8 years.
It's a long time. All of these are yours.
Everyone?
But they're so different. Day versus night. Sane versus, well, mad. Wild colours on some. Why?
I don't know. A few weeks back, that's how things started to seem.
About the time you started coming on to me.
Extra tuition. A coffee is not coming on, Natalie.
No. Why am I here, then?
Well, you wanted to see my stuff.
And to see you. Picasso changed his style every time he changed his woman. That's what you said.
Did I?
You've changed your style, Tom.
Look, you're my student, Natalie.
What the hell does that mean?
Probably nothing.
Well, come here, Mr. Swinnerton.
This is the best part. The relief. Yes.
Relief?
From tension. Is he interested? Does he like me? Will our naked bodies fit together?
And?
Well, it works. All of it.
Even under the eyes of another man?
I like Tom. He can stay.
So little's known as to why it all happened, but here in his house, in the rooms where he and Jane lived, sometimes I feel his presence.
Richard?
Yes?
Feel my presence? I love older men. They're so grateful.
Studied the subject, have you?
No, it's all bullshit. I've only had lads all drive, no direction.
I'd forgotten how it was to be hungry. To want someone that much.
Hungry for me?
Oh, hungry for everything.
Hungry for more?
It's late.
Your wife?
I thought you had a class.
I have. In bed, here.
A body. Young. Firm. No waist, long thighs. Yellow light. Green shadows. Under the white breasts. Heavy. No. Not Jane's. No, younger. Smaller. Natalie. They belong to Natalie.
Tom.
What is it? Jane?
It's Clive. He's sold two paintings.
What?
The self-portrait, the biker. There's talk of an exhibition in the spring. I knew it. Suddenly, the years, the trying. I knew it when you found your way back to colour. I am so proud of you.
How do we handle this? How much?
8,000 smackaroonies. Oh. Clive says that's just for starters. With good reviews, the prices will climb skywards.
Oh, fantastic.
I know 8 grand isn't that big, but to us...
2 paintings, 4 each.
A nude?
What? She sort of developed.
Don't you need a model?
Well, not always.
She's nothing like me. Blonde, no. Thin, tits like Bakewell tarts.
Yeah, it's the menace, the waiting, the yellows and greens of putrescence.
Maybe you should immortalise me.
Maybe I will.
I shoved that bottle of fizz into the freezer.
That bottle's time has finally come. I might scrape this picture off.
Oh, leave it for a day.
How much again?
8 big ones.
After commission?
Yes!
The biker?
The self-portrait.
Wonder who bought that.
Who the hell cares?
Don't you want to see the studio?
Not just yet. I want to take in the whole house. Enjoy my privileged position.
You're putting it off. You're scared.
Richard, don't you know the best part of any horror story is waiting for the axe to fall?
Tom? Oh, they're in this room. They've come back. He wants to show her my studio. She keeps putting him off.
It's only a dream. Bad one, that's all. Did you see them?
What?
The man and the woman in your dream.
No, just voices in the darkness. Like they were lying in our places, in our bed. Our room. The only picture I could see was on the wall opposite. There, a man staring out with mad, pain-filled eyes, his lips holding back a scream. Me. I was looking at myself.
Just a bad dream. Champagne, excitement, last class of your teaching career tomorrow, all mixed up together.
It scared me.
Sleep now. Everything's fine. Sleep.
Jane. I scraped that nude away.
Hi.
What did you mean, last class?
I've sold some work.
Goodbye teaching?
Yeah.
And goodbye me?
I don't know.
You're only selling now because of me?
No, Natalie.
I woke you up. You said that. Change your woman, change your style. That's what you said.
That's what you said.
Your wife wants you now. You're making money.
I haven't decided anything.
Will you ever?
I've a doctor's appointment.
I think I'm pregnant.
No, you're not.
I could be.
I'll be in touch.
Yes?
I'm having your husband's child.
All these works.
Yes?
Let me arrange for others to see them.
That's not possible, they're mine.
Jane!
You piece of crap!
What?
Your girlfriend's been here. No wonder you scraped that nude away. It's her, blonde bag of bones, no tits. How could you?
Listen to me, please.
She says she's pregnant.
I used a condom. She can't be.
Oh, well, that's all right, then.
Look, she's making it up.
I don't care whether she's up the stick or not. Why her? Why betray me?
Betray? What's betray? I had a weak moment.
I've supported you. I've worked for you. I've given you my life. And now you turn to some bit of stuff who thinks she's your bloody muse. The mother of your child. Look at you. I hate you.
Jane, stop it. Stop it. Ow, stop.
Why? Why her? Why this? Why now?
You don't want to know.
I want all of it.
I realised how stale I was. Held down by you. Yes, Jane. No, Jane. No wonder I was getting nowhere. I was flattered that a young woman wanted me rather than a sour bitch who was choking me to death.
You bastard! Haven't you anything to say to me?
I need to get away.
Over my dead body.
Don't tempt me, Jane.
Here we are.
The studio. Just as it was.
The murder happened here.
Murder? Whose?
Jane? What?
Wait!
What a talent died that day. Two blows to his skull with an axe.
Didn't his wife die too?
Suicide. More blood, Lily. There's a knife. Like Tom used to scrape paint there on the easel. Careful. It's still sharp.
Yes, it is. The painting on the easel?
An unfinished portrait of Jane. Quite a handsome woman, I leave it there. Climax of the tour.
A tour nobody can take but you.
Well, you're here, aren't you?
I paid my entrance fee. The bodies were found in front of the easel.
But how could you know that?
I know.
I exist here. Kept here to pay for my sins forever. I listened to your voice, as did my poor Tom. I killed him here. Jealousy, rage. How could I live after that? I took up his knife. We paid with our blood to bring Tom's work into the world. Now a talentless parasite like you, Richard, hides my husband's work away in the darkness.
Lily! Jane! No! Please!
Let's hope the next custodian is more generous. It is finished. Rest in peace, Tom.
Poor Tom. Oh, dear God, what have I done?
In Voices from Another Room by Philip Martin, Neil Dudgeon was Tom, Jenny Howe, Jane, Chris Moran, Richard, Katie McGuinness, Natalie, and Jamie Barbakoff, Lily. Original music was composed by Tom Smale. The director was Peter Kavanagh.